Hey everyone, I'm Duskull, that gamer. This game is Gone Home. I've actually been following this indie game for a while, partially because of the people behind it, and partially because the game, the studio that made it, lives in my hometown. In fact, I know where the fuck they are. But anyways, though, not my hometown, they're like in the city I'm currently in. That said, though, the people who are behind this game involve a few people who previously worked on the BioShock games. Particularly people who helped with the story writing in BioShock 1, as well as the BioShock 2 DLC of Reverna Den. We're gonna be breaking straight into this. Outside of that, I know it's supposed to be a quote-unquote, if I'm quoting them, a house exploration simulator. So, we're going back home, I guess. Use the arrow keys to walk, or WASD. Look around using the mouse. Novel. A cassette tape, that's actually kind of cool. You don't see many of those today, but we still have a few laying around our house, so. Oh! The game's resolution just changed. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do about this. I guess I'll just make the screen bigger. Might freeze for a second, but it's because suddenly the resolution of the game turned really big. Not exactly sure why either. Set and set. Actually, I'm going to have to move it a little bit so I can see the chat. I would like to read you guys as I play.
Hi, Mom.
Bye, Mom. All right, let's see. Perfecto mundo. Outside of this line at the top. Let me get that. All right, should be good. Let's continue.
So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
Gabby's suspicious of the strange symbol between the gone and the home. June 7th, 1995, 1:15 a.m. I would have been like 3 years old, almost four at the time. Regardless, looks like we've broken into the game world. Not too much else to see or say. I'm gonna jump over this. What? You can't jump? What the fucking hell? Okay, so in most games like this, usually shift is the run button, but apparently in this game it does super zoom in. Apparently the right mouse button does that too, which means I'm guessing this is interact. Yep, here we go, put back. Press right mouse to examine held object. Move the mouse. Oh, I see. So you can pick up objects and rotate it in front of your face. Well, what I can say is this definitively looks like a cup. Not a very fancy cup or anything. Can you throw it? Yep, you can throw it like in most things. And it stands up perfectly still. It will do that every single time. Nope, it can land on its side. That's the future innovation of technology, folks. Cups on the side. Alright, let's see. I've got my bags here. Where did I come from? I guess I can find it like this. Caitlin Greenbriar. So I'm guessing that's her name. Our destination is Portland. Hey! That city sounds semi-familiar to me. Flight number is 270. Date is June 6, 1995. I know physics, the future. I as far as I can't see where is that a door or I guess it's a door because over there it looks like it's a very dark, rainy night. Ah well, let's oh, wait. Lamps. Ha. Never thought I'd see the day that I would be so happy to see something like a lamp. Is those Christmas light? Yep. Apparently we got our Christmas supplies ready for every time of year. Maybe on this side? No? There also was a key under the duck, I saw it. But first, it's a duck! Whack! You don't understand, I am a huge ass fan of ducks. I don't even know why I like ducks. But, whack. More like I like cartoony ducks. This would be a fucking awesome rubber duck type thing. I mean, it doesn't have legs, so technically it's a disabled duck, but, you know, it'd still be a very nice thing to have. We're gonna throw the duck over there. Duck can have his fun time with a cup. Whack!
Lightning and thunder.
Anyways, yeah, I know. They keep the key under the freaking duck. Who saw that coming? I certainly didn't. I was just opening it. I have a backpack. If I look at my... which one? I click something. Okay, my ID. So here's my ID. This is apparently what I look like. I look like one of those stars from the 1990s, so I guess it's appropriate. This is 1995. I have green bra. Here's all of my information. Everyone, here's my security information, my social security number. Here's my credit card, and have a blast. This is back when going on airports was super extremely easy. Here's a funny story, actually. Back when I was very, very young, our family had to go to Canada. The problem is, for some reason, since I guess I was the firstborn child, my records were really hard to get hold of for whatever reason. It's partially because my mother's from Canada, and I guess they just didn't hold on my birth certificate and all that. So they let me cross because I was a kid that would not fly in this day and age. But I was just going to say that there's a huge difference between how you used to be able to travel to places in these days. Katie, I'm sorry I can't be there to see you, but it is impossible. Please, please don't go digging around trying to find out where I am. I don't want anyone, Mom and Dad, anyone, to know. We'll see each other again someday. Don't be worried. I love you, Sam. Well, that's something to come home to. Hello, note. We're just going to accept that my brother or sister Sam is forever missing, and it is impossible for me to save them. Got it. We're gonna go inside anyways. I'd be suspicious about lights coming on by themselves, unless, of course, we have a house full of the stuff. That said, it's a very nice home. Close that. Coat rack. Light lamp.
Experience the darkness of my soul.
No, anyways, let's see. Okay. We're gonna sort of circle around the house. Actually, the mount sensitivity is super low for me. Let's see if I can change that. A comment which I can say is, so far I'm enjoying the sound design of the game. In fact, to make sure you guys can hear it, I'm gonna open up the sound thing. I'm not sure if the music here is loud, quiet, whatever, but it sounds kind of quiet to me, so I'm going to turn it up a little bit. Sam could be a boy's or a girl's name, so Sam is a sister. I'll take that as a must, then. We'll figure out as we get there. Oh, holy hell, the resolution keeps on changing. Change it to this resolution, and give me a second, I'm going to readjust everything, because the resolution in this game does keep on changing. Alright, if I move that here, and move this there... Alright. Should be good at that extent. Perfect mundo. Alright, I accept all your things. What I actually wanted to do, though, was I was going to change my mouse sensitivity to the highest it can be. That is much better. Alright, open the door. Turn this light on. Is there a light switch? Typically, you look for it. There we go. Light switch. Alright, we got nothing much to say. Wait. There's a magazine.
Examine this.
Author magazine. Stephen King. 50 contests with up to $21,000 in prizes. You know, back in the old day, that could get you quite a bit of gas. Ha ha ha. Making 1990s jokes because fucking gas. Critiques, the art of feedback, get punished the secret. The blank page, how tiny top authors conquer. Let's see. Close the door, need some privacy. That's all I need.
Towels?
Kind of weird that they're in the middle, though. Typically, to make more room for towels, you put some on the left, some on the right, but...
What am I talking about? Their house.
Hi.
We got some cleansing paper.
Is that really? Well, let me check. Is that called cleansing powder? Okay, I misread that.
I was gonna say.
On the toilet with you. We have some more in here and some hand soap. We need to put our extra storage one inside the freaking sink. I think I figured out how to wash my hands. Over here, let's see. Is a box of band-aids. We're making a little concoction right now, so no, not down there, through there. Alright. Toilet paper next. There we go. My parents would be pleased. I'm making themselves fucking restroom soup. So you can interact with the law in this game. That's the first thing I'm noticing. There's a paper here. What do you have to say?
Wellspring Movers Inc.
1287 Harper's Drive, Forest Grove, Oregon, 1971. Oh, actually, they did their research. As a person who lives in Portland, Oregon, I can say this right now. The location they're mentioning is actually a real place in Oregon, in Portland, in fact. Forest Grove, as well as the IP or the zip code, are about right. This is probably based somewhere on a real place, though. Since I definitely know the zip code's right and the city name's right. Alright, facts. Let's see. Turn green bar, all that. Boxes. However, though, having moving papers is more than a little bit suspicious.
Dear Katie, so much has changed, even just since you've been away. We moved into this house. I'm in a new school. And my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier. It doesn't feel real. But I'm not gonna let it faze me. I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person, because you're off gallivanting around who knows where, I'll tell it to this journal. Just like I was talking to you.
That was a damn heartwarming moment. Let me turn this up a little bit, though. Yeah, yeah, yo, Justine. Alright, so I'm guessing that's my sister.
I'm gonna grab the tissues right now. I can see this story's gonna be a heartwarming one.
Tear jerker. Ah, whatever. Go back down, you. Will the lamp turn on? Ooh, papers. You don't see all these when the lights are off. It's because light reflects. Hang anything inside the drawer. It's just a little shy drawer. Just let come out slowly, and soon it's more afraid of you than you are of it. Damn here. Just a lot of post-it notes. I guess they want to give the feeling for people who come in that they are a very productive, thoughtful family. I'm gonna try this door next. It seems to be a closet. Where's the... There we go, light switch. Okay, we have Goodfellow High School, which, by the way, is not a real high school to my knowledge. And we have an ID. Can I get it? It looks like it's... What is that? Janice Greenbar, who is a forestry service, and I'm guessing that means that's my mother. Senior conservatist. There we go. I forgot you can zoom in almost. Also, front hall. Intriguing. Save electricity or something. Turn that off. Close. Now, I'm the aesthetic gamer, obviously, and I liked little details, and so far this is very much appealing to that. Ooh, a skull. It's a skull which appears to be for the celebration of the Day of the Dead. Hencho in Mexico. Day of the Dead has always been a fascinating holiday to me, which is why this is going in the toilet. Nah, I'm just gonna leave it there. With the box of tissues and everything else, I wonder if those positions save. We also have our trophies in the art of Regional Track and Field Finals, April 22nd, 1991, Girls Lawn Jump Event, Caitlin Greenbar. Apparently, I am a good lawn jumper. That makes it sound like I could jump in this game, but nope. And then we have a first place thing here. Pick up one of my trophies. Regional Track and Field Finals, okay, Girls 100 Meter Relay. Both things I apparently obtained back in 1991. That was my birthday, actually. Well, when I was born. All of 1991 was my birthday. No, but what I mean, that's a book. Why is this book more special than all the others? It's gotta have a name. Let's get closer to a light source so I can actually read it.
Book source, book source. What do you have to say to me?
It is the Holy Bible. Ha, of course. Yeah, that's not gonna stay in here. See you later, Bible. That's a subtle atheist joke. Anyways, let's take a look. Very nice painting. And that's a vent. Got it. Let's open this up. It's locked. Well, that's not conspicuous or anything. Let's go this way. I'll be honest, we don't keep many doors in our house locked. I look around. What is that? It is a boom country. County. Whatever. Open this up.
Worldwide timetables with pencils and all sorts of sticky notes. Our family was the sticky note center of America.
I'm assuming that's us. Sam, Katie, Mom, Jan, and Dad,
Terry.
So, I know I'm this one, I think. Or is this me, or is that? Dad, you have a cool mustache, though that's usually known as a pedo mustache, but I think it looks good on you. You just keep on going, you fucking beaver.
I love my dad.
Grab phone. No one's picking up. Can't say I can call anyone. Can't say I can look anywhere. Can I put it? Yeah, you can put it back nice and steadily. Messages.
Sam. Hello? Sam! Sam, where are you? Really? I need to talk to you. Please be there.
Hi, Mom. So I got my ticket home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so, love you. See you soon. Bye.
So, phone messages hinting that we may have been suspicious that there's no one home. At least no one was apparently answering my calls previously, but I came back home anyway from apparently a trip in Europe. Let's turn the lamp on, let's read this. Sam, Daniel from the old neighborhood called. He wants to come to see the new house. Call him back. Mom, Daniel is a total weirdo. The only reason I ever hung out with him in the first place is he had a Nintendo when we were little. Alright, well they were leaving notes about some guy who's gonna check out the house, which I guess means that they were gonna move out, in which case what am I doing here?
Questions arise. And did they move?
Our pictures are still hung up, so that implies that we're still here, but let's go in here into the fucking lights. I can have a map? Yeah, I'm updating my map apparently as I go. There's the light switch. Ooh, it's like a hallway. We had a nice house. Hey, it's one of the postcards I sent. From Paris. Alright, this is sent in... Wow, I was on a trip for a while. This is on August 2nd of 1994. Why was I gone for, like, at least a few months? Probably a year. Because, yeah, this was almost... I was apparently on a trip in Europe for almost a year. Because this is right now June in 1995. Hi, Mom and Dad and Sam. I'm in Paris. I have done many Parisian things, including eating Le Petit Déjeuner and wearing a beret. Yep. I'm going to have lots of film to develop when I get back. Sam, I'm bringing you back something from the Shakespeare Book Company, since you are my favorite sister. Love you all. Katie. Mom, Dad, and Sam. I, Arbor Hill. Boone County, Oregon. 1971-41, USA. Weird. We got 3 stamps and... gotta put that over there. Yep. Anything else? You know, for a second. Look, it's a cutout article about some guy I don't know. And a photo. Let's look at it this way. Is it my sister? DeSoto. Kind of random to have a picture of someone apparently in the military. Nice hair color, though. Another closet. We have a lot of these. Now, another note. Welcome, new student. We hope that you are as excited about your first day at Goodfellow Hill High School as we are. Please be sure to bring the following with you to the first day of classes so that we can get right into the swing of things. 1 study folder with pockets for each of your 6 class periods. 1 line notebook per period, or 1 large notebook with 6 divided sections. At least 6 pens, blue or black ink, and 6 pencils. 1 box of colored pencils. A standard combination lock for your assigned locker. A nutritious lunch, or $2.50 for a lunch provided by the school cafeteria. A positive attitude. Please remember to get plenty of sleep the night before and be ready for your first bell to ring at 8 p.m. See you soon, and again, welcome. I can almost never read teacher signatures. Am I the only one? Some of them are legible, but I can almost never read them. Beth Valance, principal.
Oh my god. You are so lucky you finished high school before we moved into this house. So, it's the first day of school, and there I am, introducing myself to the class. And I say that I just moved into the house on Arbor Hill. All of a sudden, every kid in the room turns and just stares like I suddenly transformed into a mutant. I just stood there, wishing pretty hard for a rewind button. Because now maybe nobody knows my name, but they all know who I am. The Psycho House Girl. Great.
Yai.
First day of school, add to backpack. Close that there. What's down here, actually? Nothing? Actual stuff down here. We got our exciting postcards, letters, notes. We have papers lying around just everywhere. Nothing in these drawers, though. Alright, last thing to check. Yeah, grab the pen. If anyone comes towards me, I'm stabbing them. We'll continue this way simply because what's here? Another very dark room. There we go. Close the door, let's investigate a little bit. Lots of books, but apparently nothing worth reading. Except the Holy Bible! Go, fan, go. That looks like it would barely cool anything, but okay. It works, I guess. Another Boone County book. We really like this telephone book, apparently. Alright, I'm noticing newspaper articles of that. Papers and a drawer. Another note file. Exam form. Alright, electrical inspection form. Name of injured applicant, Terrence Greenbear. Property address, Aberhill, Boone County. Let's see what y'all wrote. Does the entire electrical system need local codes? Yes. Are there any deficiencies which need connecting? Unclear. If yes, describe in detail. Wiring in house is technically up to safety and amperature requirements. However, multiple layers of wiring have been added into structure over the last 100 years. Your system is frequently unpredictable. Lights blink out for no clear reason. Pressure of floorboards and door frames disrupts circuits wired directly behind the surface. Property reworking the electrical system would be highly destructive to the walls, floor, and fixtures of the structure. After discussion with the Green Bar, since there are no current safety concerns, issues will not be addressed. Company name, Black Cat Electrical Co. Remember, kids, if you want to have your electrical system taken care of, call Black Cat Electrical Co. License number, Hardwell Prince Jr., signature, and a date of 94. Not very long after I sent my postcard. Alright, so there's some excuse to why the lights keep on going out around this house. Totally not anything else going on there, of course. And inside here, we have a book. Alright, this book. Let's see, The Killing of JFK, A Theory, Benjamin Almud. You've seen the movie, Discover the Truth. I actually know more about the subject than I'd like to admit. My dad has a very huge fascination with the murder of JF Kennedy. I'll talk about that some other time, but there's a very interesting history about that. But that said, I don't have a huge interest in it myself, it's just, yeah. A superb work of speculation plied with amazing skill and showing a level of magnetic artistry not usually present in such academic pieces. A thrilling theory. I couldn't put this book down. An important new look at the circumstances surrounding one of the greatest tragedies of our time. Cool to know. What time like paper time? Pioneer CLD D703 Combination Laser Drive Compact Disc Player. Going for $999. Was it worth it? We couldn't quite say. But give me a moment. Another second. And back. Alright. Yes, PK, I got pooped on by a fucking bird near the JF Kennedy Museum. It was not fun. I had to fucking dip my head in the fountain that's nearby the JF Kennedy Museum. Because, I mean, it was better than fucking bird poop on your head. There you go, now you all know. I fucking dipped my head in a national monument, because, anyways, there's glass. I guess I'll throw it this way. Yeah, it didn't shatter. Only foot there, but... Oh, mountains. Still, though, I forgot about that till you mentioned it right now. I think I suppressed that memory, but no, you just reminded me about it. You can do better. What if JFK wasn't JFK? Easily a space-fluent utopia. Advanced technology, end World War II early. Time segment too different? Huh. Seems like we have someone here who is very fond of good old conspiracy theories. Chinese, Japanese, Lebanese. Paradox results in JFK's death being desired outcome. Record JFK off HBO. Magic bullet theory. Lone gunman. X-Files. Check up, Sam. Alright, grassy, kind grammar. Let's see. Imperialist in USSR. Lone killer of Marines. State of emergency in Dallas Canals. JFK. These all look like different handwriting, though. So were they made by the same person? Why not distribute? So, back to basics, sent back to time, to Dallas 1963 again. I feel like this is more conspicuous than we might imagine, but someone here really was fascinated by JFK's Kennedy's death. Is it important? I don't know. Nothing there. Grab three-ring binder. You can learn a lot from a binder, but there's nothing inside, so yip hip hooray. My parents are going to be pissed if they come home and they find out I'm throwing everything around the house all over the place. Empty paper and sticky notes. We were just... I swear, we probably bought more sticky notes than anyone else in the fucking Portland, Oregon area. I was going to say the fucking... Oh, there's a lock here. Yes, I need a combination. When I find that, I'll keep in mind. Alright, so we're going to go deeper. More books. One of them looks shiny, but apparently not. Is that one shiny? Bishop Gray. Well, that's all we need to know today. I wish I had a house this nice. I mean, I'm not really, I don't need a huge ass house to be happy. Stranger Under My Roof, the number one best-selling advice book for parents of teens, Dr. Lisa Meninia. Here we go, some information in case you ever were curious, so yeah.
Sometimes they say mysteries are best left unsolved. I'm not sure I exactly agree with that, but it is true that sometimes some things are better left off unknown. Now, this book. It's telling us about a stranger under the roof of understanding teens. The teen years are fraught with it's basically just trying to tell us all the things that you can expect teenagers to do. Talking about strategies about parents to deal with teens, and fuck you. Okay, not to lay on the cover. It's just something for a second that fixed itself. So yeah, she is a lovely lady, and let's see. I never had such a good conversation with my daughter. It's the lag there. I'm hoping it resolves itself because I've done everything I could. I know it's not the internet here. If it is, it could be live stream, but. Watching it like a hawk, it looks like it might solve itself. This lady on the cover, she's very mad. She is staring very disapprovingly at the fucking kilobytes per second down there. Shake your head, lady.
Shake your head. Scare the bad lag away.
And I played catch the book, cause the book could be catched, and I caught the old book, and I threw it down.
Thus the book was a book indeed.
Play catch the book, cause it makes me go squee. I'm throwing book because it's a hook. I'm throwing this here book cause of misery. Now I'm throwing it as I go split, cause I'm throwing book for me and free. I'm gonna throw it up and down, working it out. Livestream, wow. Gonna come up and see what's going on. Throw the book. Throw the book.
Oh.
Now the book is down. I can't sing with the crap of me. That's okay, let's see. Stranger. Be a stranger indeed, be a stranger in need. Learn about understanding teens. Just call 1-800 Under My Roof by Dr. Elisa Medley. I hope this is a good book. The relationship between a parent and a teenage child is always somewhat strained at times, but they both love each other most of the time. The teen for a while may think that they don't love the parent, though given that sometimes some parents don't deserve love, there's some pretty bad parents out there. But a lot of the time, it's all part of teenage angst. I'm just gonna ram this book against this wall right now, it's gonna really enjoy it too. Blah, 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 blah. Look at that hooligan on the cover. You can tell he's a hooligan because he doesn't tie his shoes. Got a skateboard, is wearing fucking nacho chips on his shirt. And he's wearing tiger stripes, Pikachu swim trunks. So that's a guy, a baseball cap. He's got one of those horrid MP3 players. I think we're getting all controversial in here. Dad and Mom do not approve. They aren't very happy at all with his choices in life. After all, could you support a son who decided to wear nacho cheese chips on his fucking shirt?
Yeah.
Bumblebee stripes. Anyways, regardless, you know you got a dangerous one over here. Also, look at Mom and Dad there. I just want to make a comment on this, because Mom's got a little heart on her apron. Glasses looking all concerned, like, oh my dear son, where did... And then Dad's over there, he's got a fucking sweater vest, gray jeans, and he's just looking, his like, where did I go wrong? He's got the slicked back, nice combed hair, and... Yeah, anyways. I wonder what this book is going to imply. Regardless, see you later, Book-a-Gator.
Book. Why did you, of all people, have to betray me? I worked hard for you, Book. I threw you in the air, I don't know how fucking many goddamn times. And I can gain better at it for the better or worse. I was missing you at first, now I'm getting really good at catching you. But then I missed. Oh. Oh, well. Book!
Where the fuck did... Oh, there you go. You were over there. Now there's lag. Book.
So is it you, Book? Are you the cause of the lag? It wasn't there until you showed up in my life.
Fuck that book.
You know, this room. Back to my other cooler room. Let's somehow fix things, though the game performs the same in either room, so I don't think it's that.
I mean, honestly, I don't think this is gonna fix it, but you know, it's just sometimes you gotta hope. Is there a piano noise for a second?
Huddle up with this here book.
This one's a lot easier to catch because it's a lot bigger. I say that and I miss.
I'm gonna first pick up this box of lamps and I'm gonna fucking mess around with the... Oh, what is this?
That is a decorative sound of fucking tissues. I wish I had tissues that were that nice. I've never seen a real-life box of tissues with a pattern before. Maybe it's just because I'm a guy. I don't fucking know. I bet you guys probably seen fancy-ass tissues, but...
Yeah.
I'm going to continue. I'm going to be the stubborn feller. I'm going to walk forward and hope it resolves itself out. Even though I know this is on livestream at this point, I'm just going to continue.
Hold my chin high. And try.
I swear to God, I hear a piano. Like, it's very faint. I barely notice it. But there's the sound of a piano. Somewhere. It's kind of haunting, actually. Let me open this up. Wait, there's a combination here for the lock. 0451. November 1st, 1994. Dear Terrence, David asked me to write to you regarding the reviews you've been submitting to the latest last few months. Frankly, they are becoming more trouble than they're worth. From an editing standpoint, there's a word limit. It's your job to stay under it, not mine to cut back to it, even though it's becoming harder and harder to weed out the tangents and non-sequiturs from the usable copy without heavy rewrites. the readers of Home Theater Avocino, I can never say that word. It looks like Alfredo sauce to me, but whatever the case. Want to hear about the quality and value of the hardware, not ruminants of your childhood. If it were up to me, I wouldn't be running this lair, just be cutting you loose. There's a ton of guys half your age who would take half your rate to write stuff I could actually use. But David's known you for a long time, and he's the boss, so I'm giving you one more shot on his say-so. You should write him a nice note thanking him for his patience and generosity. Look through your old stuff and start submitting reviews like that again. Then everybody will be happy. Brent Covewood, ReviewZ, or Home Theater, and the magazine. Fancy. Now then, we have a code here. 0451. Evidently, that's probably supposed to go over here, so 0451. There was a lock over here I didn't have the combination to, and I'm supposing that's my clue. So, 0451. I'm correct. Here's another document. A document to a document. Okay. Kubelik and Wise, attorneys of law. Dear Mr. Mason, please find and close your original document and a typed copy for your records. The notarized copy has been filled at our office. Thank you for entrusting our firm with the important matter. Sincerely, I cannot read that cursive, Japanese Wise, Kubelik Wise, attorney A at law. Will and testament, Oscar Mason, for his processing the full competence of mind and memory. And after full survey of valued items to my name, to hereby declare this document my last will and testament. The following shall hold true upon my passing. 1. I declare that I am a lifelong resident of Boone County and I am unmarried and have no children. 2. I declare that I have no outstanding debts to my name, to my creditors, living or dead. 3. I do hereby bequeath every item of value of which I may die possessed, including the dwelling and surrounding acres located at Arbor Hill, as well as any and all personal property and I moneyed accounts, to my nephew, Terrence L. Greenberg, Jr. of Killis County. So did we, like, inherit this house from someone who used to live here, like an old family member? In the event that said Terrence L. Greenblower Jr. should predecease me, then in such event, the bequest of him shall fall in the same as bequeathed to his children as ordered by age and competence as stewards of the estate. I subscribe my name to this will this 13th day of August 1973. Signed, Oscar May. And let's see, can I read that? Looks like it's the same thing, just in cursive. I can't read that cursive either. So yeah. In which case, back over to exploring. Open sesame, checking stuff out. Okay, there was a man's voice. I heard it earlier. It was coming from an on TV. What does the TV have to say? Call me curious. Storm 5 watts, severe weather warning, western region. So we're having a weather alert for the storm going on right now. Grab this plane. Can I knock the plane into the soda can? Yes, you can! That's fun!
The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties: Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Tecumseh County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
Sam thought this might help, Dad. Making friends even when you're part of it, you can't read because it says this note on it. Even when you blame. That has to be important. Philip Ackerman. Feeling lonely? It's a piece of cake to make friends. Never worry again about having friends to spend time with. This book will teach you to make friends even when you're shy. Even when you're shy. Alright, so apparently we're supposed to be very shy, I'm guessing. And I guess
you know that feeling where the first moment you see someone, it's like they have a big gold star around them? and you have to get to know them. Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk. But sometimes I see her in this, like, army uniform. She's always drawing in this notebook, looking so intense. I had no idea how I would ever, like, have an excuse to talk to her. Till I noticed she and her friends hang out and play Street Fighter at the 7-Eleven every day after school.
You. You Street Fighter maniac. I know. I think we're all sensing things there. Let's see. Let me turn on the lights. Grab my box of tissues that are all over the place. Oh, those are nice looking too. Why don't I have nice boxes of tissues? Even if this one looks pretty, excuse the terminology, groovy. Regardless though. Videotapes and VHSs. You don't see those many these days. Here's a cassette. It's got a Girl Scout note on it. Can I put it inside here? Let's try. I can honestly say that's not what I was expecting when I put in a tape marked Girl Scouts inside. Oh, that was the flip side role model. Alright, let's put in this one. No, we want the one about Girl Scouts. I'm only getting a role model. How do you flip the tape? No, I'll just put you in there. Enjoy yourself. Let's take a look around right here. A lot of VHS tapes. Fair enough. Anything else around this area? Pizza! You know, that's probably some of the best pizza stain graphics I've had, but all I gotta say of that is, pizza stains. What does this say? David Warning, Avocado Magazine. This is from that magazine thing I think that David's my dad was working on. Let's see. Can't say too much more, just some information. Interesting paintings. Stormy outside. And again, a whole bunch of receipts and notes. We just left our notes laying around everywhere. Here's the TV listing. We're really excited, apparently, for the X-Files. That reminds me, that was supposed to be by a person who was in the other area, because he was mentioning the JFK assassinations as well. And the X-Files was mentioned there. Still, what can you do? If you want a piece of the X-Files, then yai. Everyone, you got a role model. Here is a... what is this? Oh, it's a little fern design pamphlet. Put that there. Nothing there. Nothing here. And there's a coaster of a clover. Cool. Now, how about around here? We got several VHS tapes, including one down here, which is the Dark Castle? Dark Crystal. Right. This one is X-Files Season 1, Episodes 18 to 21. I have my sneaking suspicion someone here was really enjoying the X-Files. I don't know why, though. Why I get this sneaking suspicion that the X-Files was a very famous show here at the house. Let's see. Airplane, Moonraker, Beetlejuice, Blade Runner, Director's Cut, JFK, X-Files Season 1, Episodes 14 to 17, X-Files Season 1, Episodes 10 to 13, X-Files Season 1, 69, X-Files Season 1, Number 3, 4, and 5, X-Files Pilot, plus some extra stuff.
They're all over the place with this X-Files thing going on. Here is the Andomede Strain. Is there any other markers on this stuff? I mean, I like the X-Files, not as much as these guys did apparently, but the Time Machine clue, Fantastic Voyage, Top Gun. Those are some very short VHS tapes, that's all I can say on it. There's a letter. It's that book Dad wrote. Let's see what my dad wrote. The Accidental Savior, related him on John F. Kennedy. So it's my dad who is super obsessed with John F. Kennedy. November 21st, 1963. John Boswell's known that the president's life hangs in the balance, but who would believe him? Not just another James Bond, a high-class political thriller. In case you really care about, I guess it makes sense. My dad was pretty obsessed with that stuff too. Give me a second though, I forgot to put my Steam back online. I just tell that Steam to go back offline and put it back in its place. It's not learning whenever my peoples are playing games. Let's read the letter. February 3rd, 1978. Terry, hey man, how are you been? How have you been? I know you're a published author and everything now, but my editor at Hi-Fi Alpha Kono has too much, okay, that's too much review work to go around, and he's looking for another freelancer. Naturally, I thought of you. You were saying in your last letter how much of a pain it's been trying to find a publisher for your latest work or literature, and writing stereo reviews is dead simple. Sit at home with a glass of scotch, listen to some records, and write up how it sounds, and then get paid. I've included some issues of the mag to use as examples. If you're interested, send some samples to my editor. And tell him your old college chum, Mike, sent you. Here's the address. There we go. That's apparently how I fucking got the job, which my dad years later was having difficulties with. Alright. Oh, poor old dad. I'm gonna go this way. Is that the typewriter moving? Let me check. I swear to God, it sounded like someone was clapping on this that tapping. That would have been this typewriter over here, right? Not suspicious. Let's go on. If I break over this direction, there has to be something I can find, right? Open this door, and behind it, is this another closet? It's another closet. This one we have, it looks like a card. It has a lot of turtles on it. In case you like turtles, there's your turtle card. So this looks like the TV room, sort of an entertainment room, and that's fine. You usually keep it closer to the front of the house, though, in my experience. It's kind of weird it's past two more personal rooms, but what do I know? Maybe it just felt right to them. Grab a bunch of coupons. Look at all those coupons for me to save 25 cents. Pretty extreme. Off you go. Pictures of mountains, examined pamphlets. U.S. National Forestry Manual, Northwest Region, Prescribed Burn Procedures and Precautions. Because if I'm correct, my mother was a park ranger. Key down through here. Now, what is in this room? Lights on. Ooh, looks fancy. Interesting pictures. This is like a little bar area. Just sit around and enjoy a cup of coffee, tea, whatever. We have a series of books, or are these records? Those are too thin to be books. Those are definitely vinyl records. They ain't stick out, though. That's a lot of records. But here we go. Let's play this record. What is the record, though? It is... looks like a Mary Goose rhyme. Got a need for you.
Somehow I always knew that someday we'd be through. Now that it's happened, I just can't believe it's true. I've done the best I could to keep from feeling blue.
Reproductive System Worksheet 6 by Samantha Greenbauer, which is probably my younger sister, Samantha. And she wrote this... 1994. Okay. September 9th, 1994. Directions, blow our two stories. The events are all out of order. Yes, she is blind paper, right? Reproductive System Worksheet 6 at the top. Then she's one of the two stories that are being rewritten. Begin with the title and your name. Find a topic sentence to begin your paragraph. Put the sentence in chronological order. Make sure the last sentence is a good concluding statement. The menstrual cycle, it travels through the fallopian tube. The ovary releases the ovum. About 2 weeks later, since the lining of the uterus is not needed for pregnancy, it comes out through the vagina. It is incredible how the female body knows how it is prepared for pregnancy. If the egg doesn't meet the sperm, it dissolves. While the ovum is developing, the lining of the uterus is getting thick and soft. Another ovum starts to develop in one of the ovaries, and spermatocytes begin again. The ovum starts to develop. Iron produced in the testicles. I go via the deferens of the urethra, the life of the sperm cell. I go through the cervix and the uterus into the fallopian tubes in search of an egg cell. I develop for 2 or 3 months for the epididymis. When the penis becomes erect, I have the epididymis and travel up into the body through the vas deferens. As I pass the postal gland, the cerium versus of the Cropper's glands, without me an egg cell would begin the amazing process of reproduction. Urethra carries me along with about 200 million of the sperm out of the penis in process called ejaculation. If I can find the ovum before the other sperm do, I will be the winner part of the fertilized egg. There's a little bit of note here by Samantha here. Now then. Careful, guys. I know that it's easy to crack jokes about that, but it's just science, so yeah. Now then. We go this way. Samantha Greenberg, period 4. Reproductive system worksheet. The early morning of September 1st, 1939, Essa Glancy stares out the window of the train as it travels from Vivian Bank to her home village of William in Poland. As the train rumbles along and the sun rises over the countryside, she can only think of her dear Borislav, the boy she is engaged to, the boy she's engaged to wed. Meanwhile, deep within her gut, an ovum starts to develop. Oh, I see. You're supposed to put all of the words into a sentence, into a paper. That's kind of weird. Deep in her guts, an ovum starts to develop. Essa's train approaching its destination. Her heart, the lining of her uterus is getting thick and soft. That's not odd at all, but yeah. I forgot. I never did an assignment like this in terms of reproductive classes, but English class. There was assignments where you had to fit in sentences. They gave you a few sentences. You had to fit a story around. No, we did not do that in a class about reproductive systems, but yeah. As Essa steps off her train, her eyes dart quickly across the gathered crowd. Then there, her dear Boris, still in his baker's smock, he must have dropped his early morning duties at his father's shop to come meet her. Her heart slips a beat. The ovary releases the ovum and travels through the fallopian tube. Okay. That's actually pretty funny. It's because it's telling two stories. Obviously, Samantha here wanted to write a story about two people meeting each other after a long time. But of course, because it's in for a reproductive class, it's kind of funny because it sounds like a story about two people meet each other after a long time, and then it just randomly sentences about fallopian tubes and ovaries, and it's gonna get weird, I could tell. Over the wheezing of the steam engines, a deep hum grows. It's coming from the sky. Dark shadows pass over the station, a whistling sound. As say her, thoughts only of a second faster than the bombs reaching out to word, her dear bonds across the cloud. Their eyes look, and at that moment freezes. The flash and smoke envelops them, almost hesitantly. In the assault by German forces, almost 75% of the people in their hometown are killed. The rest, including Ursa and for a time, Borislav, huddle in half-destroyed city. He is blind, his legs are missing, bandaged with the bedsheets. Essa's egg will not be meeting a sperm. It dissolves. About 2 weeks later, Boris loses his grip on life. Essa has given up her rations to be with Boris to keep Boris alive. But in the end, nothing can save him, since the lining of the uterus is not needed for pregnancy. It comes out through the vagina. Essa vows to survive, she sets off to join the Polish resistance as a daring spy and saboteur. Another ovum starts to develop in one of the ovaries, and the process begins again. It is incredible how the female body knows how to prepare for pregnancy. Poetry. And then, of course, there's a teacher note just saying, "See me?" I mean, I can see what she's doing. It's pretty funny. It's a joke because it's a reproductive system set up. Actually, the game describes itself as a house explorer simulator. That's what it says on the Steam page. You learn so much. So there was a tragic story about Polish resistances and ovaries. Now, if we go over this way, turn the lights on. Health class. We go over this way. Actually, there's a door in here. Is it another closet? It is another closet. It's another closet. Full of books of ours. Apparently, we got a lot to put in storage. And a lid. Full of what else? But more books by my dad. Seems like another one, though. The Accidental Parallel. Our dad was... Okay, so obviously I think I can connect to this game on a personal level. A, I live in Portland, Oregon. B, there's all sorts of stuff about JF Kennedy, and apparently the dad of this girl was obsessed with it. My dad is kind of the same, so obviously I have connections here. Read the note. Katie, please tell Mom and Dad sorry about the stuff that's missing. Sam, why is my sister writing me notes? Grab lip balm. What flavor? It's lip stuff. I don't know if I... Oh, cherry stone. There you go. Bunch of coupon. Oh, wait, are those dice? They're dice. Let's roll it. See what I get. You know, I'm going to throw the dice in the air and see what I get with two dice thrown in the air. I get 4 and 5. That's a 9. No, that's just a power socket for the lamp, right? Guess we're gonna check this door. Oh, that door's locked, so we're finally done exploring this single hallway. We got a very big house. Thunder and lightning aren't so frightening. Da, 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 da. Just keep all the doors open simply because it shows that I'm alive and I've been here. There's still so much more to explore, though. We're finally back in the foyer. It's been a while since we've even been here. I'm just gonna say goodnight to the Bible. Good night, Bible. And try and check out what's going on upstairs. Deep into the second floor of Chandeliersville, darker and darker. Except the lamp's now on, so it's not quite as dark. Ooh, an interesting design full of wheat. And a picture of a flower that works. That was something else, to be honest. Controlled burn scheduled for Boone County. Boone County. Flames of smoke will rise above the northeastern region of Boone County over the better part of the next week. As part of Forestry Service, run controlled burn of overgrown sections of Flintlock National Forest. Forestry crews have been preparing the area for months. The burn operation will take place between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and possibly on a Thursday, depending on speed of progress. According to the Forestry Service, in addition to removing dead and overgrown vegetation that can lead to wildfires in drier months, the operation will serve as a valuable training tool for the forestry and firefighting personnel involved with senior conservationist Janice Greenbar. So it's, there's our my mom, I guess. Smoke will likely linger in the area, so my mom was apparently like a badass forest fighter. Together, let's open this and that, and congratulations, we've learned stuff. Light, there's the light. Another long-ass hallway coming. Read personal calendar. Weekly planner. Oh god, I can't read this. Couples bowling? Is that what it says? Are they going couple bowling? Cooking class, ballroom dancing. I think that says couples bowling, cooking class, and ballroom dancing. Crack the big meal for Jerry and Sam. Interesting. So I know it's cooking classes and all that. It's just kind of hard for me to read his handwriting like that. A lot of pens and a forum. Notice temporary personal transfer. Bruce Penrill, head of personal state forestry service, to aid in the upcoming prescribed burn operation. This is a 94, though. The overseeing officer of Flint, Jersey transferred. So I guess my mom was transferred. I wonder if that means she was transferred here or transferred elsewhere. Open this stuff out. Any cassette tape. Let's bring this cassette tape with us. Oh, that's odd. Brat Mobiles. Is there even a tape in here? Oh, it's an empty cassette thing. It says something on the other side, though. What does it say? For Sam. Love things to be cherry bomb, throw away, PRDCT, some special fuck ya falls, Polaroid baby, painkiller bitch, theme, Richard, cool, small, juice land, blah, blah, blah. Wait. It says something on the other side, which is really hard to see. You're going to like this one. That's what it says. You're going to like this one. All right. Put that over there.
It's weird hanging out with girls. Daniel was around ever since I was little, and other girls? I don't know. But being around Lonnie is like instantly just right. I gave her the grand Psycho House tour and took my revenge on Super Nintendo. And it was like, I don't know, I finally found someone I feel normal around. I drove her home and she gave me this tape and said, "You have got to listen to this." I haven't stopped playing it since.
So are we in love with the army girl? Maybe. We'll find out. Sam, stop leaving every damn lie in the house on. You're as bad as your sister. Daniel called again. He wants his Nintendo game back. Daniel called. Wait, I wonder if Daniel's jealous? What do you guys think? Think that could be going someplace? To whom it may concern, I, Samantha Greenbrier, am 17 years old and am therefore an independent, fully functional human being. The fact that you still forbid me from going into the city on my own is frankly absurd. Compare with Katie, who is only three years older than me, and yet you allowed her to go all the way across an ocean to another continent on her own. I just want to spend an evening in a normal, totally safe city on my own, like a human being. And since you may also remember that I have my own car now, you can't really stop me. Warmest regards, your daughter Samantha. Seems like our sister was quite the character. Caution, radiation area. This is probably my sister's room then. Alright, let's see. See what this says. Place for a cassette tape. Screen binder. I'm guessing there's cassette stuff around. Clothing and a cassette tape. Who knew?
We're so cool, yeah. Yeah, we're so cool, cool. We're so cool, yeah.
Huh. Let's see, we got clone cables and cartridge. For Adventurous the Cat Returns. If you can find his Nintendo system somewhere, we can probably put this thing in. For the Adventurous the Cat Returns. Let's put that down there. And a thing code. Chun-Li moves. Fireball, hold, plus punch, lightning kick, 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 kick. Helicopter kick, down, hold, plus up, plus kick, air stomp, down, plus H cable jumping, MK.
Okay.
Street fire moves. Alright, TV on off, I'll leave it on for now. Pretty nice. Stare. Just strange designs, I can't fully say I understand. More Nintendo games. We have Super Spitfire. For the good old CMP Interactive. Boy, I threw that to a place I can probably never get it back again. You are Journey of Crystal. This one looks very fancy. Journey of Crystal, don't you know? Still though? Let's see. I haven't had that much to drink, Jodie Foster. How many fingers am I holding up? You better not have been reading my secret diary again. Here you go, Min. Have some pate. Rose. Oh, there's a code here. Alright, so I need some combination or something. Alright, read clipping. Sam, I think the Creative Ryan track would be perfect for you. Miss Blackwell. Summer pre-college programs for young schools, 1995. So is my sister away at college? Actually, this is a real college where I am. Reed College. It is an actual college in Portland, Oregon. Yeah, it's actually a very nice college, too. I can tell you this one. It's in a very nice location. You can see a screenshot of it there. It's kind of away from the main city part, but it is a very sort of high-class college that's here. It specializes in medical and technology firms. It's a school mainly for those who are interested in medical sciences, sciences in general, and schools for those who are interested in technology. So, yeah. I can comment a little bit more on this, so I know a little bit, and apparently she's interested in English creative writing, anthropology, art and history, classics, mathematics, philosophy, religion. You know, you mentioned that there, though. It seems like it's slightly spin. I'm not sure how the school was in 1995, but I can't say how it's like currently. Now then. Let's see, a lot of stuff to still see. We have Goodfellas again. Glass cup, turn the lights on. Grab a hairbrush. Gotta comb some hair. Gotta cut some hair. We got little shiny stickery stars to look at when we're probably laying in bed. Yep, as I expected. Alright, lamp. Something here. Grab Steggy Stelly. It's our sister's favorite dinosaur plushie. It's a Stegly. Steggy the Stegosaurus. Say hi, everyone, to Steggy the Stegosaurus. Steggy's really happy to see you. He's really happy to see you. Here goes Steggy. Here goes Steggy. Steggy, Steggy. There goes Steggy. Meow. Steggy's on his way, because Steggy, you see, has very important business to attend to. Steggy wants to believe. I guess she was into the X-Files, too. How much of my family was into the X-Files? Or was it just my sister? Someone in this house, though, at least one person, really liked the X-Files. I need to rewatch the X-Files. I liked it, too. Just not when I was a kid. I liked it because I used to watch it around. I had a TV in my room, but it wasn't a really fancy TV. It was a TV that didn't have cable, and one of the channels that came on had the X-Files that played. It was the Fox channel. And the Fox channel in question, well, it used to play at 11 p.m. o'clock my time, so every night on a weekday when school was going on, I'd stay up and I'd watch the new episode, just an episode of The X-Files, and then I'd go to bed right afterwards. I'd go to bed at midnight each night because I'd enjoyed The X-Files, and as such, I mean, I have some nostalgia for the show. So everything in this is sort of relatable. I didn't have a Stegosaurus plushie. Speaking of plushies, when I was a kid, I had a plushie of Liz. For those who don't know what Liz is, it was the lizard from the Magic School Bus. I got it when I was a kid, and I had it for a fucking long time. I always liked Liz. It was always my favorite character in the Magic School Bus, so... yeah. Not a Steggy the Stegosaurus, though. Steggy the Stegosaurus is... you know, that's Steggy. Now, Steggy's gonna go watch the X-Files or some shit, so see you later. And Steggy, fun times. There's also something under the bed. Samantha Greed Blair, year 11, teacher, Fletcher, period 5, subject, shop 1, assignment, Mel works, craving, grade C-. Not a challenging assignment, Mel plague, for family portrait was a reasonable subject, but not complex. When I said that mom and dad should be replaced with parent names, I did not mean just add them underneath. Acceptable leveling on edges, shows more pride in work. We have the X-Files, I want to believe, and all that. A box I can't open, clothes thrown on the floor. Anything else under this bed? For sure. For the Brother 150, of course it's a Phaedrus, new for 1965. This is the one me and my dad are building. Wanna go for its ride when it's done? Alright, so I guess you really want to make that, and left a fork around. Our sister wasn't exactly the cleanest girl around, though, was she? But that's okay. Through here, and Milius. a Pacific prostitute of our exhibit, and that's that picture. I know that from the other time when I played Mermaid Swamp. Also school pirates. Enjoy your pirating as you can. Kinsect presents Sonic Boom 94. May 7th, Tycoon Fairgrounds. And it's a closet. How many closets are in this house? Man, Sam had this in like 4th grade. It is a pretty flippin' cool notebook. There's something underneath too. A book. Holy Bible. What am I gonna do with you, Bible? Here's the board game. Got your number. Are you going to dance with anyone? I just got a crush on you. Got your number. Do you like sports? Would you introduce me and your friend? Are you busy Friday? So what, you date the board game or something? I don't fucking understand. Anyways, I'm gonna go over this way and take this Bible where it needs to go in my house. Alright. Excuse me, fire monitor. I am gonna take you over here. Back to the front of the house. Making my way as I'm going. Gonna see you out of the front door. You guys do some Bible cuddling. Now then, back out we go. Now, I still haven't finished one of my sister's rooms, so let's see. Oh, you guys are talking about the desire of marriage. Marriage isn't for everyone, and it is for me, though. I am intrigued. I'm a romantic at heart, so I have the desire to be married someday. I guess there's two entrances. Danger, wear goggles and rubber gloves when handling anything in this room. Fair, fair enough. So I can see the type of person her sister was. Notes and a lot of organized books. It's for a guy, I still hear a piano. It's weird because it pops in randomly. It's very faint. Hey Sam, do you want to see Pulp Fiction after school in the Coliseum? It came out last weekend and Todd won't shut up about it, so either it's good or we can make fun of him for liking it. My mom was supposed to cook dinner for us tonight for a change, but I can't just stitch out of it probably. What time? Also, isn't that movie supposed to be really violent? Am I going to barf? According to Todd, it's pretty hardcore. I guess Uma Thurman gets stabbed in the heart with a heroin needle, so that kind of is hilarious. Also, something about cheeseburgers is important, Todd, I can't read that word. Suggest to see it again. Is it okay? Don't barf. Ha, alright, see you then. Someone doodled a cheeseburger barfing. Over here, ferns and a door. Lights, restroom. In the cabinet, we have such exciting items as band-aids, nail polish. We have toothpaste. And we have band-aids to make another restroom stew. Make that restroom, make it. Go in, toothbrush. You're in for the ride, too. Another hairbrush. Down here is probably toiletries. We have a tampon, which can be joined in. There you go. And grab emergency band-aid in case you ever want to be emergency fabulous. Now then, towels that are actually organized to an extent this time. Is that hair color? Let's see. Wild color, red, right hand. So I'm guessing that's what this is, because it almost looks like blood. If I wasn't mistaken.
Lonnie brought her hair dye over today. She said, I need to fix these roots. Think you could help? Dyeing hair is weirdly intimate. I don't know if I've touched someone else's scalp before. That's pretty intimate, right? It felt intimate. We looked in the mirror together after, and I expected her to say something about how it looked crappy, or good, or whatever. But that's when she said, you're so beautiful. And she was looking at me. Right in that moment, I wanted to say something, but I waited. And the moment was gone.
So far, what I will say, it seems that my sister was in love with the Army Street Fighter girl. That's what her name is to me right now. Flushin'. I'm enjoying the game so far. It advertises itself as a house exploration simulator, and so far that's what I'm doing. So, let's see. Open sesame. Turn the lights on. Open drawers. Those are indeed clothes. How about you? Your clothes. Your jeans. Your socks. Your whatever. Pants, I guess. Yeah, undershirts. And yeah, undershirts. Alright, down here we have mom's purse. Mother? Put down the bed. Or at the foot of the bed. Nice little paintings. An Earth Day benefit celebration. Hussy for the planet. Earth, Wind, and Fire, and Willie Nelson. America, Jackson Brown, the Pointer Sisters, Gary U.S., Linda. Actually, Willie Nelson's a family friend of ours, so that's always cool. So I can tell Willie if I ever see him again, because he's getting old and it's been a while since I last saw him, that he was mentioned in this game. He'd probably just laugh at that. Anyways, gonna go this way, turn this on. Postcard? Looks like a watchtower there. Dear Mom, Dad, and Sam. I am in the channel. This is from me. I am in the channel. This is my second passage to the channel. I'm on my way back from London, this time doing the Brussels, Belgium. Sorry I didn't write you on the way to London, but I was too excited about the channel. London was great. Dad, I know you've always wanted to visit, and I think you really should. You'd love it. If you all wanted to come back here as a family sometime, I guess I could be convinced. Love you all. Katie, Mom, Dad, Sam, all. Oh, they kept it there. Right next to their bedside. At least the phone lines still seem to be working. Anyways, anything under the bed, Mom and Dad? Some shirts and stuff, I guess. Here we have a shirt, some jeans. More things, more things. Look at all the things. And, aw, Mitten. Mitten the cat that was drawn by me, apparently, when I was 5 years old. Good old Mitten. Bye, Mitten. Put you back. That's adorable. Here's a book. It is Leaves of Grass. I recognize this guy, Walt Woven. Interesting. Put down the bed. Alright, anything else? Nope, I'm being a sneaky. Actually, here's in the bookmark. Alright, Timberlands Booksellers, new used hardcover paperback periodicals. Locating historic Wisteria Town Center, your local source for literature since 1933. Take your time. I'm glad to have it in good hands by Rick. Alright, we got a guy named Rick involved. Here's another box of tissues and another family portrait, except that we're much younger. Look at how young they look as a parent of the photo upstairs. Memories, apparently. And a 3-stream binder with absolutely nothing in it. Well, they've got stuff in it, but I can't see it. And here's a note. Dear Jen. Oh, honey, let me tell you, I understand how you feel, but Bob and I have had our down periods. It's because a bit of a way of life, actually. You get used to each other. You live your own lives in the same house. The kids grow up. They go away. I'm sorry this isn't helping, is it? Don't worry, Terry. Terry will get over whatever's distracting him. Things will go back to normal, and as for Sam being distant, that's a teenager for you. Nothing to worry about. In the meantime, though, this controlled burn that sounds like quite the adventure. But let's cut to the chase. This new Nanjin they sent? That's what I want to hear about. Ranger Rick? You have to be kidding me. It's too perfect. You have to tell me everything. And pictures. I want the whole package. Wait, that's not wrong. Keep your chin up until Terry is out of his slump. And in the meantime, write more letters to your old friend Carol. She adores them, Carol. So it sounds like my dad was in the slump, partially because he started writing a lot. So my dad seems depressed on the other side of the house. He's been telling stories about... Apparently he was starting to write more and more personalized. Apparently start sounding like he was getting crazy about the murder of JFK. There's JFK notes everywhere around the places where it seems like he preoccupied. It seems like he started getting obsessed with that. My sister started getting distant, started falling in love with another girl doing teenager things. Sounds like my mom started having a potential affair with a park ranger at a job named Rick. That's all I've put together so far. So, yeah. Let's see. Left, right, all about. Inside here, we have a book. Watercolors technique for flowers and still lifes. Are you watercolors looking to improve your skills? So was Bradford Gregory once. Since he began painting with watercolors at the age of 40, he has gone on to win countless awards in national and international exhibitions. Now, with watercolor technique for florals and still lifes, he shares his years of watercolor experience with you. This book doesn't contain a list of rules, but principles and concepts that will lead you down the path to fulfilling your own personal potential as an artist. I put that back. I go this way. Not too much else to see. Slide that door. There's a second door here, but it doesn't seem to be too much else actually in this location. Anything inside a hamper? Just some socks. How about inside here? We got a TV. Having a very fizzy look on it. What does mom watch? Butch Cassidy, the Sundance of the Fugitive, all the Residents' Men. We have Blint Slackroom, May 20th, a blank tape. Sarah Music, over here we have Bridge on the River Kauai. Silence of the Lambs. Alright, we got several films set up there. Is that? No, it's just like pants or something. This is probably a personalized restroom. Cool, cool. Combs, playing with my fucking stink stew, toothpaste, in the cabinet, we have shaving cream, and band-aids, toothbrushes. I was like throwing stuff around, apparently. Another toothbrush. There's another door in here. I'm guessing it's a shower room, and on the count that there's no bath shower in here. Or toilets. It's probably a toilet, actually. Like a toilet and shower area. Let me turn the lights. Bathtub, toilet, here's a book. Ugh. After the honeymoon, rediscovering your spouse, personality, spiritually, and sexually, Reverend Alex and Michaels, after the honeymoon. It may seem inevitable that the spark you and your spouse share on your honeymoon should fade over time, but it doesn't have to be. Reverend Alexander Michaels will show you how to rekindle the fire you once had. Part 1 provides simple steps to reopen the lines of communication between you and your spouse, allowing you to face the problems you share as partners instead of rivals. Part 2 leverages the Reverend's decades of service to God, helping you connect with a higher power. It'll draw strength from the spiritually you may not even know you have. Part 3 offers a number of fresh and exciting ideas for the bedroom, including a few things that may surprise you. The reserves of passion for your spouse run deep. You just have to know where to look. Reverend Michael will show you the way. So, yeah, it seems like Mother was having issues. Now, candles. All in the bathtub with you. Alright, well, I missed that one. Very creaky. This house is very creaky, though. Nothing there. How about down here? Just a bunch of towels, toilet paper, and lightning. The storm seems to be worsening, though. At least lightning has become a lot more frequent as I continue exploring, and seems like things are still starting and continuing pretty well. Pretty nice storm, or a bad storm, depending on how you look at it. Alright, down this hallway. Peekaboo. Okay, Christmas lights, of all things. That's kind of odd. We'll get to that in a little bit. There's a note here. Katie, Mom and Dad were going to make up for the guest room for you to stay in over the summer, but you came home on such short notice that they weren't around to do it. You can use my room if you want. I won't be needing it anymore. From Sam. Did my sister run away with that one girl she fell in love with? You got paintings. Boxes all stored up. I'm guessing this is the guest room they were preparing for me. Exam and composition book. Samantha Greenblair, Ghost Hunter Journal. A Ghost Hunter Journal. Let's see. Sighting Journal. August 31st, 1994, 1:19 a.m. A tall shadow in the upstairs hall. When I rounded the corner, no one was there. How tall was Uncle Oscar? Note, I was not wearing my glasses. December 3rd, 1994, 12:44 a.m. A faint voice coming from the bottom of the stairs. I said hello, did not investigate. Probably was the furnace. December 9th, 1994, 4:11 p.m. Poured milk from the carton in the fridge. It was spoiled. Pretty sure I read that spirits can sour milk. Milk was just bought yesterday. Also, ghost milk. You know, ghost milk. September 20th. September 20th, 1994, 11:24 p.m. Lonnie says she feels a presence in the TV room. I suddenly begin to feel cold. We build a protective pillow for it. October 1st, 1994, 11 p.m. to 12 a.m. Lonnie and I employ Ondrin Board as a medium. Serving messages are conveyed from the other side. Oscar is definitely here. October 8th, 1994, 10 p.m. October. Keep in mind as well, there's nothing in this house outside of like some postcards that have been made after the point of October 1994. So I haven't seen it, despite the fact it's supposed to be June 1995, there's been no signs that anyone's been here since at least 1994, outside of those notes that my sister wrote. Enslated Lonnie to stay up all night and help patrol premises, recording any signs of otherworldly presences. Lonnie reported many sightings, but all remained unconfirmed. Possible ectoplasm in attic. Probably leaky roof. Sample taken, just in case. Due to our best efforts, we both fell asleep around 4 a.m. All in all, a successful night. Alright, composition book. Let's turn the lamp on. Here's another note. Hey, Sam. You were asking what my I wrote ribbons implement. Here's a handy guide. Orienting, rifle team, adventure train. Let's hear what they all say there. This means the army. Oh, this is a note by Lonnie, the girl that my sister loves. So if you didn't think it was cool before, now you do. Telling what the different ribbons and stuff she has on her means for the army. Makes sense. So yeah, my sister and I are very evidently in love with each other. No, I'm guessing this Daniel guy was also pretty jealous of it. My guess so far. Start with K, because that's supposed to be for me. Got it. Katie. I guess I can turn the lights on at least. Doesn't seem to be much in here though. Now then, down this hallway. Torn wallpaper. Is that the first place in this area that has torn wallpaper? I haven't noticed torn wallpaper anywhere. So yeah, that's the first area around here that has torn wallpaper. I know it's just a small thing to notice, but it was the first thing I noticed. Torn wallpaper. Why is that? Anyways, let's go down through here first, before I go on. A painting room. Intriguing. It's a bowl. Put it back. Painting. Someone in the house is also a painter, apparently. What did they paint? Can't see. It literally looks like a black canvas looking at it. No, that's a bowl. Don't need to grab it. I can't make out what that's a painting of. Maybe it's a lamp. There we go. Oh, it's painting the flowers. So paintbrush. Gonna be a fucking modern day Mozart. And a note. Performance evaluation for Richard Pazmar, supervisor Denise Greenbar. So this is for... Oh, wait. Wasn't Rick. Richard, this is the performance. So this is the guy that I think that my mom was having a potential affair with. So yeah, I remember the watercoloring book. That's true. So Rick was the guy who my mom was having some sort of affair with. And he was working at the ranger station that she works at. And he's a 5 in everything. Ranger Patchmore has been indispensable during the course of the prescribed burn preparation execution. I believe his expertise and dedication has been the deciding factor in the success of a very complex and challenging conservation effort. In the opinion of the Flintlock Forest staff, Rick's contributions to daily operations have become essential to the outfit's continuing success. To this end, I will be formally submitting paperwork requesting his permanent reassignment to this facility. Jenica Greenberg. There we go. Oh. I wrote the Bible of Cactar, then I guess I'm a fucking prophet. Now, if I go over this way, here's another note. Halloween show! Don't forget your costume, the misfits, they're awesome. See you here. Siglin Lawning, 10:29, 9 p.m. Okay.
It's
Sometimes you just have to lie to Mom and Dad. Like when Lonnie asked me to see a band with her and stay over at her friend's place in the city after. That's a lie to Mom and Dad's situation. But it was so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome. And everybody was moving together like one huge tide of sound. Between two songs, Lonnie leaned over and said, "How do you like your first show?" I was so happy. I felt tears starting in my eyes. And then she up and hugged me. I think she could tell.
So, the relationship between my sister and Lonnie continues. Let's see. Something there? Not sure. Open this one up. Lights on. Here we have a book. It is about healthy choices, skills for a healthful life. And here we have some girl doing the splits, and it looks like she's probably about to jump off a cliff. Nothing on the back. Alright. You are a folder. Here's the paper. Lonnie, holy crap, I was in the library and I noticed something in the corner and I found a secret passage and it had Oscar's creepy old stuff in it? Oh my god, I have got to see this. We're skipping six. So apparently in Mom and Dad's room's closet, which I was in earlier, there is a secret passage to a library. And I was in that closet earlier, so I know where it is, the bathroom on the dad's room, I'm right now in the sewing room. Okay, so there's a secret passage there. Secret passage marked a map, press 2 or M to review. Oh boy, turn this on. And really old style clothes, I actually like it. What do you guys think? I mean, it's old style, but still. Here's some drawings of it. Captain Agrero on the first mate. It's like a pirate outfit for a costume for a Halloween party, I get it. So what do you guys think for a pirate costume? They got a little hat here to go with the costume too, and there's the actual costume. I like it. It's not cosplay, come on. Cosplay, really? It's a costume for Halloween. Costume design existed. Anyways. I have no idea what you guys are talking about. Let's see what's inside the sewing table. Oh, that is cool. Can I pop it out again? Can I pop it out? Did you guys see how it popped out? That was so... I wish I had a sewing machine. I don't even sew, but a sewing machine that would pop out like that. It looked like a fucking Transformers transformation sequence. I don't even like the Transformers movies. I hated them. Let's go over this way. No, creepy lights to open the attic, but the attic is locked. What's up with all the Christmas lights on around it? Creepy red Christmas lights at that. Sam's dark room. Do not enter if red lights are on. Well, that's not conspicuous in the slightest. Anyways, I'm going to continue this way. And let's find the secret passage my sister's been going on about. So apparently there's a secret passage somewhere in this closet. A secret passage. Was it behind the boxes? Was it in U-book? Lights out. Maybe if I close the door and turn the lights out. I'm gonna find the secret. There we go! Found it! Ooh.